So the Gullies have had a good win today. Pete, just like to welcome Peter Martin. Pete's a legend at the Tiki Gully Footy Club. And Pete, tell us a little bit about yourself. How did you end up at Tiki Gully? The short version.
Well, the short version is I met a girl that was going out with one of the boys here, and they split up, and I ended up going out with her, and then he actually was still hanging around, but he talked me into coming out to the club. So, yeah, interesting.
It's an interesting story, but no regrets about being here, because you've never left the place since, and that was way back in what? 1991. So you've been at the club for 25 years.
Yep.
That's a long time to serve a club. And of course, Pete's come a long way at the club as a smaller fella, physique-wise, probably the same height, but probably a few more kilos over 25 years. But he's been around for a long time and done a heck of a lot with the club. Apparently you are the
biggest bloke here.
No, other than the biggest bloke here.
I'm currently the chairman of the Sportsman's Club, the body in between cricket and football. I enjoy it. It's an interesting role. It's a pretty much a behind the scenes type role.
Yeah.
Look, loved every year I've been here, and it's a fantastic place to be.
It is. Pete served very well. Of course, he's a life member up here at Tiki Gully. And of course, anyone that gets life membership status has obviously put their yards into the club. And Pete's gone beyond the call of duty because he's done so much, as I said, behind the scenes. It's not just what you see, it's what happens behind the scenes as well. And he's lucky enough to have a lad now. If you want to tell us about Tyler and how he's developed through the ranks.
He's 16. He's come through right from under sixes. He's played in the 170s game, junior football games right now at the club. He's currently out at Norwood. He's been there for the last 5 years, and he's been asked to be not asked, but he's been playing up a grade out at Norwood as well. He played 18s today. Fantastic. I love it either way, whether he's playing sport. But he's coming along in leaps and bounds. He's a 6'2 lad and still growing. He played state under 16 football this year, which a very proud moment as a dad.
Yeah, of course it would be.
For me to watch him playing sport, footy, and achieving a lot of goals at such a young age, and just, you can't stop him. He wears me out just watching him. So,
well, they have a lot fantastic. More energy once we've hit this age that we have. The
yeah.
younger ones have got a lot more energy. And Pete's obviously very proud of Tyler, and he will hopefully be another footballer that goes all the way, that's been through the junior ranks here at the club. And we're lucky enough to boast about some approximately 50 players now that have gone on and played league footy or AFL football, and that's something that I would put a challenge out any club in Australia that have got a number anywhere close to that. And of course we're a big junior program, and Pete's been a part of the juniors and the seniors, so we really appreciate what Pete's done. And besides that, he's been a premiership coach, and if you'd like to tell us about what happened way back in 2001.
I suppose my coaching career goes back to, I'm from the Riverland, Luxembourg, and it goes back to those days. I coached some footballers back then that played league football in Brook Frogden, and he's one that come to mind, but I just love seeing kids achieve a lot of milestones. And 2001, I come back to C grade football, obviously from A grade level here, and just loved it. More relaxed atmosphere, but just really enjoyed it, and played myself at the time as well.
Advantages of being a coach.
Yeah, pick myself every week.
Yeah, of course. And it's great to see that, whether you're a young fella or an old fella, it's the older ones that help the young ones come up through the ranks of the club, and they like to hang around. It's such a good place to be.